One of the best ways to have a warm house in the winter, keep the heat out in the summer, and save energy is by installing double interior clear plastic storm windows, also called window inserts. You can build them to custom fit your windows for a very reasonable cost. They look nice, are super clear, and can last 30 years or more. Most walls are R11 to R23, while single pane glass is less than R1, and double pane glass is about R2 up to R3 if it's argon filled with a low E coating. Adding 2 to 3 layers of clear plastic can increase that to R5 to 9, dramatically cutting your heat loss, reducing cold air infiltration, and keeping condensation, ice, or mold from forming on your windows. I would recommend double or triple storm windows for every house, especially if you have single pane glass or live in a cold or hot climate. For non-opening picture windows with a flat surface at least 1/4 inch from the glass all the way around, clear polyester film can simply be taped on the existing frame with double stick tape. You can build a wood frame for additional layers. The ideal airspace between glazing layers is 1/2 to 3/4 inch. Some opening windows also have a flat surface that you can tape the film to, as long as you have at least 1/4 inch of airspace. The advantage is you can still open the window with the storm window attached for fresh air, and it will reduce or eliminate condensation. You can add a double storm window inside that for 5 layers total, a well-insulated window. Glass filters out most of the UV rays from the sun. Plastic will only last 1 or 2 years outdoors unless it's UV stabilized. Putting it inside the glass protects it from the UV, wind, hail, and other elements. My last storm windows lasted 35 years, and then it was the tape, weather stripping, and unvarnished wood that went bad, not the glazing. Most windows have a flat jamb extension all the way around, and you can build a compression fit storm window to fit it, using open cell foam weather stripping to fill the gap and hold the storm window in place. You can also split your frame into 2 windows, so you can slide it open for fresh air. If your opening windows have a screen inside the window, you can build a storm window the same size as the screen. In fall, we take out the screens and put in the storm windows. In spring, we take out the storm windows and put in the screens, or vice versa in a hot climate. You may need a place to store storm windows and screens you take out, like a shelf in a shed or a garage away from sunlight and dust. The best glazing is 3mm clear polyester film, which also goes by brand names Mylar and Duralar. It's so clear you can barely tell it's there, reasonably priced, easy to install, lightweight, strong, and long-lasting. You could use thinner 2 or 1mm polyester, but it will be less durable. Our dog clawed this 3mm polyester film, but it was strong enough not to puncture all the way through. Polyethylene tarps are cheaper but very cloudy. Vinyl is strong, quiet, and flexible, but costs more and is not as clear. Polyester is very clear. See video description for more information and links to materials. There are some tricks to building frames, taping, and stretching the plastic. For a compression fit, I use 1/4 inch thick open cell foam weather strip around a wood frame of 1x2s on edge. It's important to measure the inside of your window opening accurately on all 4 sides. Most tape measures say how much to add for an inside measurement. Here we have 25 inches plus 3.5 is 28.5 inches. Or you can bend the tape real sharp into the corner, or there may be an edge that you can measure to. 1/4 inch weather strip will compress to 1/8 of an inch, times 2 for both sides, and your wood frame should be 1/4 inch smaller than the opening in height and width. After building the frame, check to see that it fits easily with a piece of uncompressed weather strip. If it's too tight, it will be hard to get in and out. If your windows are not very straight or you don't want to be so exact, you can use 1/2 inch thick weather strip or make your frame 1/2 inch smaller than the opening and measure to about the nearest 1/8 of an inch. Make drawings of all your windows and their measurements to figure out materials and frame sizes you'll need. One option for building your frames is to miter the corners at a 45-degree angle, which uses slightly more wood, shorter screws, and is easier to figure the lengths to cut. I didn't mind cutting the ends square. It helps to measure and cut accurately. A chop saw works best, but if you don't have one, it can be done by hand. For the length to cut the inside wood, subtract the width of the outside wood. 1x2s are usually 1.5 inches wide, but measure to be sure, these were only 1 3/8. The frame size needs to be accurate to fit well. Another option is to figure the lengths in centimeters, which are easier to subtract than fractions of an inch. Once your frame pieces are cut, pre-drill the ends to avoid splitting the wood. For 1x2 wood, I'd suggest 2.5 and or 3-inch screws. I drill 2 pilot holes from behind, as it's easier to be sure they are centered and will hit the other piece in the right spot. Use a square and hold the 2 pieces in place, then drill through to the other piece from the outside. Countersink for the screw heads. Having 2 drills saves a lot of time changing bits. It helps to clamp it, or better yet, have a solid backing to screw against. Putting wax on the screws helps them go in much easier. Tightening the last bit by hand helps prevent splitting the wood. You can use nails, but I'd still recommend pre-drilling and brace the frame well while you pound them in to keep it from bouncing all over. For long and tall windows, much over 4 feet, it's good to add a divider in the middle to keep longer sides from bowing in. Bare wood will turn dark over time, so it will look nicer and the tape will stick longer if you varnish it with 1 to 2 clear coats or else prime and paint it. Allow it to dry thoroughly, sand lightly with very fine sandpaper, and remove the dust with a tack cloth. Use clear Gorilla Tape to make a tab for removing the storm window later, leaving at least 1.5 inches to grab a hold of. I make a small roll of tape inside the end and double back over it. Another option is to drill holes and, after taping the plastic on, run an 1/8 or 3/16-inch braided nylon cord through for a handle. Once your handles are done, use fine point tweezers if necessary and peel the backing off the open cell foam weather stripping. Stick it all the way around the outside of the frame, taping over the Gorilla Tape handle and cutting it square on the corners. You can use either 1/2 inch or 3/4 inch wide weather strip. Check again to be sure the frame fits in the window and you can pull it back out with your handle. Stick the double stick tape all the way around both sides of each frame and press it down well. Cut the corners with a utility knife or scissors. When you're ready to mount the plastic, measure to the middle of each side, slit the tape backing, peel it back and crease it, leaving the double stick tape on the frame. This can be a bit tricky. You may need a sharp knife and some tweezers and good lighting. Hang your roll of polyester on a dowel or a pipe where it can rotate, and you have enough space below it to pull the plastic down for your largest window. Make sure the area is clean, otherwise static electricity may attract pet hair and dust to the plastic. Place your frame toward the front of the window jamb. This will square up the frame with the window opening, especially on larger windows. Now for the most fun part, pull the length of the plastic down that you need for that window. Measure and mark it about 2 inches bigger than the frame. That's just enough to hold on to while you stretch the plastic and stick it to the frame. Stick some removable tape on what will be the top 2 corners. Holding onto the edges so as not to drop it, cut the piece off the roll with a razor-sharp utility knife. Carry the plastic over to the window and stick the 2 top corners to the wall to hold it there. Now stretch the plastic from top to bottom in the middle and stick it firmly to the tape. Stretch also from side to side and again rub the plastic firmly against the tape so that we have a diamond shape in the middle that is tight. Then pull the backing off the double stick tape and stretch the plastic straight outward on each side, working your way to each corner, trying to avoid wrinkles as much as possible. Rub firmly over the tape to stick it well. Don't pull the elastic toward the corner, but rather perpendicular to the wood frame. Take the window back out and trim this inside plastic about a quarter to half inch past the edge of the wood as a vapor barrier to seal and cover over the weather stripping. It's hard to cut a straight line freehand, so you might want a strip of wood or a metal straight edge as a guide and use a new sharp blade. Slit those outside corners on a 45 degree angle so it can bend as you push it into the window opening. This prevents moisture from condensing on the weather strip. If your window corners are very square, you can flip it and tape the other side, or else pull the storm window out and find a clean place to lean it while you prepare your tape and stretch on the second layer of plastic. On this outside piece, trim the plastic off right at the edge of the wood frame, which is much easier. The insert is now done. If taping directly to a window frame, be sure to wash and dry the window thoroughly first, because once you tape the plastic on, you won't be able to get in there to clean it again. Ideally, tape it on when the air is cold and dry so you're not trapping moisture inside, or else it may fog up in cold, sunny weather. To clean plastic storm windows, use a plastic cleaner like Novus or Brilliantize, and a microfiber cloth which will clean and polish without scratching. Alcohol may work on stubborn spots. It can take a week or so to design and build all the storm windows needed for a whole house, but it is well worth it. List and measure all your windows, figure the maximum width of plastic film you'll need, and add up the total length. Where taping plastic directly to a window frame, you'll need only plastic film and tape, no weather strip. For a double pane insert, remember to double the plastic film and tape, but only one perimeter of weather strip. For large windows, splitting it into two pieces may use narrower plastic and be easier to store. Weather strip and 1x2 may be found at a lumber yard, but the double stick tape and clear polyester film I have only found online. See links and more details on materials in the video description. When I built my first Mylar storm windows, the house immediately felt warmer. We burned about half as much firewood, and they lasted 35 years. They only cost about $10 to $20 a window, and you can save hundreds of dollars a year in heat. Feel free to like and share this video, and comment or ask questions below. Thanks for watching.